Hi, this is Maggie Kamb, class of 2021 and student guide at the Mount Holyoke College Art Museum. Today, we will be looking at a statue of Guanyin from our permanent collection. Are appearances everything? For many Buddhists in South and East Asia, outer grace and conduct is interpreted as a sign of inner virtue and wisdom, and yet the current appearance of this Guanyin is quite a departure from its former glory. It came into our possession in this truncated state, missing its arms and legs. You can spot small details on the figure, such as pins in the arms, suggesting that this wasn't always the case. Notice the traces of varnish on the figure, seen here on the cheek and robes, and again on the crown, and along the hairline. It was most likely colorfully painted and adorned with gold leaf. Today, the wood used to create this statue is showing signs of its age. See the cracks on the figure's face and the raw edge of the arms. This Guanyin is thought to have been made between 960 to 1368 CE in the Song or Yuan dynasties of China. Downcast eyes that avoid our gaze suggest it was probably mounted high above onlookers. Did you notice the elongated earlobes? They are popular in imagery of Buddhist saints and deities as they symbolize wisdom. On the crown is a now headless figure of the Buddha, seated in meditation. Many shrines to Guanyin exist today and are a source of refuge for practitioners. Guanyin is the Chinese Buddhist version of the Indian Bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara, the one who listens. Bodhisattvas are Buddhas in training who have sworn to attain enlightenment and free all beings from suffering. Avalokiteshvara, and thus Guanyin, is revered as the embodiment of the virtue of compassion. One of Avalokiteshvara's powers is the ability to take many different forms to best help those in need. This malleability is perhaps what allowed Guanyin to make a distinct departure from the rest of the Buddhist canon. Although the Bodhisattva can take many forms, Avalokiteshvara is identified as male. However, by the Song dynasty in China, masculine depictions of Guanyin transitioned to more feminine embodiments. Our Guanyin has a flat chest, but the full lips, rounded eyes, and flowery adornments on the figure suggest the feminine. One such depiction is this pair of porcelain Guanyin statues from our collection, made in China in the early 20th century. Over time, Jesuit missionaries of the 16th century would nickname the Bodhisattva the Goddess of Mercy, a foil to their symbol of compassion, Mary Mother of Christ. The appearance of this symbol of universal compassion has changed dramatically over the course of its long life, as did the narrative of the Bodhisattva. Still, the serenity and virtuosity of Guanyin shine through.
This has been Maggie Kamb with MH Kamb. Thank you for listening.